Frazzled nerves in this farming community between Setarsha and Holly Bluff. Where I'm standing, the storm's path is easily 3 football fields wide. It took out a small cluster of homes in an industrial building, but not Cliff Trammell, not his home. That's what's left of it over there. And he admits today he's still around to tell us his story, primarily because of the stubbornness of his granddaughter.
I've been living 88 years, and I've never been in a tornado in my life.
But a tornado did finally make a path to 88-year-old Cliff Trammell's home. Only moments before, his 17-year-old granddaughter Rachel had rushed out to see that he was okay. It was just in time.
Pushed him in the hallway. He didn't want to go in there.
She kept on saying, "Papa, let's go in the hallway." I said, "Darling, ain't no tornado coming."
But it did come. Rachel, her friend, and her grandfather had only moments. So many times we tried to tell everyone about the safest place to be during a storm is in a hallway. This is where Rachel and her grandfather and her friend stood. It's right next to the bathroom. And when the storm came, they covered each other up, and everything came down around them.
I had my eyes open the whole time the storm was hitting. I saw all of this coming down in on us. Let me tell you some scary stuff.
Scratched, bumped, bruised, scared to death. There's little left of Cliff Trammell's home, but he'll live to see another day in this Yazoo County community because of the granddaughter who would not take no for an answer, who saved his life.
I believe she did.
Rachel is thanking someone else these days.
Just by the grace of God, we're alive.
Cliff Trammell, believe it or not, does not have insurance, but he actually says he has enough money to rebuild at least a smaller version of the home that will eventually have to be torn down. He admits, though, he's not sweating the small details right now, nor are a lot of other residents in this area who are lucky to have survived this storm. A lot of neighbors helping residents who were hit by this storm collect what belongings are still left standing. Live in Yazoo County, Scott Simmons, 16 WAPT News. Megan, back to you.